Hi guys, in today's video, I'll show you how to enforce a strong password compliance as well as enable the two-factor authentication using Google Authenticator. So let's get started. Okay, let's go to the username icon. And we're gonna go to apps. So in order to enable two-factor authentication, you will need the apps for it to enable the Google Authenticator. We're gonna go to security, and we're gonna go down to you see there it have a lot of apps. Two-factor YubiKey, it's like a physical key that you plug in your computer and you're using it to log in. And right here we're gonna use Google Authenticator, which is a two-factor TOTP provider. We're gonna go ahead and download it and enable. All right, and it should be enabled. Yep. And we're gonna go to setting. I wanna go to security. Before you enable two-factor authentication, make sure that you backup the code. So in case that you lost your mobile device and you don't have the authenticator app to generate the code, you're still able to log in to your Nextcloud. So we're gonna go ahead and generate a backup code. Keep in mind that every time you generate a backup code, the old one gonna be automatically invalidated. So make sure that you save a backup copy or print it out and put it somewhere safe. All right, and we can enable the authenticators, and it's gonna ask you so you can use a TOTP secret and manually input it into your mobile device. But the easiest way is to use the Google Authenticator apps on your iOS or Android device and scan the QR code. Once you scan in the QR code, Google Authenticator gonna have six digits. And it keeps changing for a period of time. You're gonna go ahead and enter that six digits in here, the authenticator code, to verify it. And verify it. Here we go. So now we have authenticator app enabled. The next step is we're gonna go to security under administration. And we're gonna enable two-factor authentication. So if you wanna enforce this to certain group, or you wanna exclude certain group from the two-factor authentication, you can put that group in there. If not, by default, it's gonna enable for everybody. And password policies, from here you can change the password length. A character minimum length, and you can enforce upper lower case numeric characters and special characters. And you can check the password again, the list, to make sure that it's not in the compromised list. And that's pretty much it. We're gonna go ahead and log out, so to show you that the two-factor authentication actually enabled. And we're gonna log in again. Notice this time it actually asks you for the authentication code and from your Google Authenticator on your iOS or Android device. You're gonna look it up, the code for Nextcloud, and you're gonna input the code in here. and you click on submit, and there you go, you're able to log in into your Nextcloud using the two-factor authentication Google Authenticator. And one of the reason why I want to do this tutorial, in the next tutorial I will show you how to enable DDNS and enable the remote access for Nextcloud, so you're able to access this away from home remotely. And by enabling a two-factor authentication, you added an extra security player. It's gonna help safeguard your data. And like always, thank you for watching. If you think the tutorial is helpful, don't forget to give me a thumb up, subscribe or not, and I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. Bye bye.